Saw on that credit list was, though, you think of all the extras in and stuff, anybody with a camera could run off and do some nasty business for you.
We were quite lucky. I mean, compared to a lot of movies that I see happening, I think the fact we were in New Zealand, a long way away, we managed to keep things reasonably secret, did we?
Yeah.
Get the whole country on lockdown, essentially. Nobody could get in or get out. When you look back now, what do you think of as some of the key decisions you made in pre-production that allowed you to complete all three of these films in the manner that you wanted? What are you proudest of having decided early on?
That's a good question. The really critical part of the films in the pre-production was the script writing. That's just obviously the script writing and casting. If you get the script right and you get the cast right, then most movies are 70% of the way there already before you even stepped on the set. And we obviously wanted a cast that felt like they just stepped over the pages of the book. So the casting was important to us.
What role did you have the hardest time getting the right person for?
Aragorn was obviously one, because we ended up casting Viggo about 3 or 4 days after we started shooting. Ian McKellen was a problem to us because he was on X-Men at the time. And, we had a lot of times where fate stepped in to help us, because Ian McKellen was on X-Men, and we had to start shooting our movie in October 99, and it was clear that X-Men, which was running over, was going to run over into Christmas. And we had Ian sort of agreeing to do the movie early on, and that was great, but then X-Men was pushing further and further back. And the reason why it was pushing back was because originally in X-Men, the role of Wolverine was going to be played by Doug Ray Scott, who, while they were starting shooting X-Men, they were waiting for Doug Ray Scott to arrive, because he was late arriving because he was in Australia doing Mission Impossible 2, which was running way over schedule. So we were sitting in New Zealand, aware that Doug Ray Scott was being held up in Australia for Mission Impossible 2, which was stopping him getting to Canada to do X-Men, which was stopping them finishing that film, and letting Ian McKellen come to us. And we then had a lucky situation occur for us. Because Doug Ray Scott had an accident on the set of Mission Impossible 2, fell off a motorbike and broke his arm.
There are no accidents, Peter.
How much that cost us. That meant that Wolverine had to be recast, and they got Hugh Jackman, and which just sped up that production. And then I got a lot of help from Brian Singer, because I met Brian a long time ago, and I knew him, so I wrote to him and I said, listen, do anything you can, please, to let Ian go as quickly as you can. And then we delayed Gandalf's scenes and we started shooting other scenes, and it all worked out.
Just people are going to see, like, Jean-Claude Van Damme playing Gandalf.
Actually, I don't know who we would have picked. We actually didn't go there. We really didn't have another choice. It would have been bad, actually. It would have been bad for the movie.
What was the hardest thing for you to leave out of that script when you were putting it together? So faithful to the book in so many ways, but you had to let some things go.
Not Tom Bombadil. I don't know what it is with Tom Bombadil, I really don't. People say you didn't have Tom Bombadil, and that's not true at all. I mean, you've just seen the movie. That scene, you cut to the, I think you go to the word Isengard, and then we cut to the scene of the hobbits arriving at Bree in the rain. I mean, who's to say that they hadn't visited Tom Bombadil? I mean, we didn't cut him out, we weren't rolling cameras at the time.
With so many things going on, how did you find time for the actors on the set? You would have different shootings in different locations at all times. How did you actually talk to the actors about what you want?
Oh, it's all about the actors. I mean, you end up talking to the actors more than anybody else. What you do when you shoot a scene is you, usually this happens in the morning, because it usually takes all day to shoot a scene. So the first thing you do, you arrive on set right at the beginning of the day, which is usually 7:30 in the morning. after you've had some breakfast, and you block the scene. So what I always like doing is, blocking the scene is kind of rehearsing it, really. You look at what you've got to shoot that day, and you have the actors, you have the DP, and a couple of other people there, and you sort of try to just ask everybody else to leave and go and have a cup of coffee.